Hello, it's Scott Brown, the appliance guru in New London, New Hampshire. And today I'm troubleshooting a Whirlpool vertical modular washer. And I'm only partway through the whole diagnostic process, but I've got some footage together of where I've gotten so far and what I've done. Still might be interesting to you, so come on, have a look. So this is underneath here. I've got the pump, capacitor, the guard, the mode shifter. Underneath there, main drive pulley, and these splotches underneath that. There's the transmission. Okay. Belt guard is removed. Main drive pulley turns freely in both directions. And the drive pulley nut is still firmly attached. Okay, so to get into diagnostic mode, starting with in standby at the 12 o'clock position, one full rotation, and then one, two, three, back one, and then all your status lights should light up. Now you're in diagnostic mode. And to get the codes, go clockwise one more time. You should see the done status light lit. Then press the start key. All your lights light up. Go clockwise again. And the LEDs are showing the code. If yours has a display, it's also going to flash it to you. This is an F7 E1. You can look up on the tech sheet what that is. Okay, in this case, the fault code is an F7 E1. And if you look on the tech sheet, F7 E1 is a basket speed sensor fault. So you want to make sure that the tub is free to move around. You can check that from the drive pulley underneath or from the inside of the tub. Check the harness. Harness connections to the main control board and motor, and then do test number 3, the mode shifter. Okay, to get the control panel off, easiest thing to do is raise the lid. Come under here, reach underneath there, you'll feel little spring clips. Push those out to release the front of it. On the back, you have to undo this top screws here to release it from this metal plate. And then it slides out. It's held in, you've got these little plastic hooks here. And, okay, so what I'm looking for here, this is on the control board, there's a green LED. The washer's plugged in right now. If that green LED is lit, the control board is good. So that's a quick way to eliminate the control board as a suspect. Once you're here at the control board, you can test the other components. And I'm going to check out the resistance of the mode shifter motor. So the first test of the mode shifter is to measure the resistance of the mode shifter motor. And you do that at the J16 harness at the main control board. J16 harness is this top one. Here at the back of the control board, it's this top center one here. And it's at pins 1 and 2 are the motor for the mode shifter, and that's over here, the brown and white wires. And if you ever forget that, if you look down at the board with good illumination, it's labeled as J16, and pin 1 is identified as starting over here on this side.